Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I will show you how to calculate the light absorption spectrum of a benzene molecule using a time-dependent DFT package in Quantum Espresso. And so if you see the spectrum here, this is a UV and a visible light spectrum, and the x-axis is the wavelength. I'm not sure whether you can see it or not. And the y-axis is basically the absorption. And there is a peak here. You see that it is around 178 nanometer wavelength. That is UV light. If you convert it to energy, that is around 6.96 electron volt. And if you plot it in another way, that is the absorption against the energy of the photon, you can see that actually there is a peak here, and which is also this 6.96 electron volt of benzene molecule. Yeah, and in this tutorial, I will show you how to calculate this absorption spectrum, and also we will compare the peak energy of the calculation to the reference here. Okay, so let's get started. So so the first thing to do is to download some pseudopotential file for carbon and hydrogen for this calculation. The reason is that the TD-TFT package in Quantum Espresso does not support PAW type of pseudopotential. So, but unfortunately, the SSSP library that we usually use uses a PAW pseudopotential for carbon. Yeah, so we have to find something else. For the TD-DFT package, you can use either norm conserving pseudopotential or ultra soft pseudopotential. Yeah, both are fine, but you cannot use PAW. So another pseudopotential library that is good is this pseudo dojo that I already opened here. And for the purpose of this video, you can just download the carbon and hydrogen pseudopotential here, that save file, and of course you need to decompress. Or you can press download here to download the full library. Yeah. So as you see here, there are some options. You can choose this SR, which is scalar relativistic or full relativistic. You can try this around. This NC means norm conserving, which is okay. The only thing that you shouldn't try is this PAW, because this will not work. Yeah. So in this video, I will use this scalar relativistic and PBE as the exchange coupling, and the accuracy we choose stringent, so it may give more precise result. And for the format, for Quantum Espresso, you need to use this UPF format. Yeah, and then you just press download, so this will download the full library. And then you need to decompress and put it in a folder that you know. And for me, I put it in this folder here. So this is the SSSP library that we usually used before. So we put it in another folder here. If you go inside, everything is arranged according to the name of the element. So we will use carbon, and where's hydrogen? Hydrogen. Yeah. Okay. So yeah. So after the like I already put the options that I chose for the library here, so that you can also use the same thing if you want. Yeah, you can also try some other things if you like. Okay, and yeah. So the first thing to do is to relax the structure of the benzene as usual. The point is that. Why I put this here is that this is optional. If you are sure that your benzene, like the structure of the benzene is okay, you can also skip this this step, because this is a little bit time consuming. especially if the molecule is larger than benzene, yeah. If the atomic positions are around the optimum, this will only give you a small correction. So it's also okay that you don't do this relaxation. But for us, we all just do it routinely because it is always good to relax the structure before any series calculation. So I guess you are more or less familiar with the input file for the relaxation calculation, that calculation is relax. And remember to change the pseudopotential directory here. So this is the new pseudopotential directory for this normal conserving pseudopotential library pseudo dojo. Yeah, and we also lower the total energy conversion threshold and force conversion threshold to make the relaxation more precise. And this ibraf equals 6 means that this is a tetragonal lattice. So the x, y, and z are 90 degrees with each other. And x and y lattice constant is the same. That is defined here as 32 Bohr. And the z lattice constant is defined in like here, but this is the ratio between the z and the x lattice constant. So basically the z lattice constant is 0.83 multiplied by 32 Bohr. Yeah. So basically this is a molecule in the box calculation. And we set the box to be much larger than the molecule so that it doesn't see outside of the box. And we have 12 atoms because it is a C6H6 molecule, and we have two type of atoms. And cutoff wave function kinetic energy is 30. Now we use norm conserving pseudopotential. Yeah, if you use ultra soft pseudopotential, you may want to set the E cut rho to be 8 times this E cut WFC. Yeah, but here we can just set it to be default, which is 4 times E cut WFC. Okay, and don't forget this ions name card. Although you can just keep everything default inside. And this name for the carbon and hydrogen pseudopotential file, and those are the atomic positions specified in the unit of angstrom. And and here we set the z coordinate of every atom to be unchanged. So basically we only allow relaxation in the XY plane. Yeah, so this will restrict some of the relaxation process, but without losing any generality. Yeah, okay. And here the K point is gamma point calculation, because this is the molecule in the box calculation. We don't need more gamma points. It is worthy to mention that this notation is more it's better than what we did before. That is K points automatic and we say 0, 0, 0. Yeah, because this saves more calculation. Okay, and then we just save the file, and then we start the calculation. So MPI run minus MP2 and. Okay, sorry. Q3 pin, and we use pw.x and minus imp this input file and 0, 0. Okay, yeah. So this will take some time. I will just stop it here. Yeah. And the only thing that you need is the final relaxed coordinates in the output file of this relaxation calculation, which I already copied to the next step, which is the single point, wave function calculation. Yeah. So this is a self-consistency calculation, also using pw.x and you are also familiar with it. We change the calculation to SCF, and everything else we should keep it consistent. And we lower the convergence threshold here to make it more precise. I also increase the cutoff, kinetic cutoff energy for the wave function to be higher, and also the E-cut rho to be higher. So notice that this is not necessary in the norm conserving case in our calculation, but it doesn't hurt anyhow. Yeah. So yeah. And those atomic positions and those coordinates, like I get from the output of the relaxation that I calculated. Okay. So then we can calculate the self-consistency calculation. So notice that this will take a little bit longer than what we usually did before, because you see that we have 12 atoms per unit cell, and also the cell size is kind of large. If you want to reduce the calculation time, you can reduce the cell size a little bit, but you shouldn't reduce it too much, because then the benzene molecule would see other benzene molecule in the periodic lattice. Yeah, that is what you don't want. Okay. And also you can lower this E-cut WFC, and also you can safely like lower this E-cut rho to be, let's say, four times the E-cut WFC. This will also save some time. Yes. Okay, so now it is finished. And the next step is actually the most important step for this TDD DFT calculation, and also this is the most time-consuming step. On my laptop, it uses 1 hour to calculate the output, and of course it depends on your hardware, but just be patient that this will be quite time-consuming even for this small molecule. Yeah. So the input file is here. That is quite simple, and you need to keep the prefix and output directory consistent with the SCF calculation. The reason is that it needs to retrieve the wave function from the previous calculation. And also this is the iteration, the maximum iteration, because this basically calculates the TDTFT in iteratively, yeah. And this is important because it specifies in which direction you want to calculate your polarizability. So if this is 1, you only calculate x direction. If it's 2, it's y direction. If it's 3, it's z direction. If it is 4, you calculate all of the directions. Usually you should set it to be 4. And okay. And then we can do the calculation. It's turbo and Lanczos. So this is the name of the method. And minus imp c. This is 2, 2, and out. Yeah. So yeah. So this will take quite long. As I mentioned, this took 1 hour on my machine. So I will not run it here, but I will just stop it here and copy the output that I get. Okay, so I need to first delete this, and then let's copy. Okay, so this is something that we will see after you run that calculation. You will not see any data file, you will just see this standard output, which contains some information, but it's not something that you need. To get something that you can plot, you need to use this turbo spectrum.x. Yeah, and the input file for that is is basically here. Yeah. As I said before, the prefix out there should be consistent, and this 500 should also be consistent with the input file of the previous step here, and also this IPO equals 4. That means that you want to calculate the polarizability in all of the directions should also be consistent with the step before. Yeah. And then this maximum iteration, it means that we want to calculate those points, but excessive points are calculated using the extrapolation method specified here. You can also try other extrapolation methods, but let's say we use this OSC here, and this epsilon is the smearing term. Yeah, so basically if you get it too small, you see too many oscillations in the spectrum. If you get it too large, it will smear out some of the details of the spectrum. So for this 0.01, this is in the unit of Rydberg, and it is around 0.1 electron volt. Yeah, then that is usually okay. And here this is the unit. If you don't specify this, the default is Rydberg. Yeah. For convenience, we set it to be 1, which means that everything is in electron volt. Okay. And then this is the start point of the spectrum, the end point, that the end energy of the spectrum, and the increment of the points in the spectrum, and those three lines are in the unit specified here. Yeah, so if you don't specify anything, everything is in Rydberg. In our case, we specify electron volt, so everything is in electron volt. So the spectrum will go from 0 electron volt to 50 electron volt with an increment of 0.01 electron volt. Okay, so for that, I can actually show you the calculation here, because this is kind of fast. Okay, yeah. Okay, so now it's finished. Let's check in the folder that you will see that it not only outputs the standard output here, but also output two data file here, which are very important. We can first check this plot key. That is the polarizability matrix, and this is the energy, and this is the real part of the polarizability. This is the imaginary part of the polarizability, and the imaginary part is basically the absorption. Yeah, and you can also see that it has 1 1, 2 1, 3 1, 1 2. So it is a really a matrix. So those are different matrix elements of this polarizability. Of course, you can actually calculate the absorption from this file. But quantum espresso is very nice that it gives you another output file. This is the plot S, which basically is the spectrum that we want to calculate. So only two columns. One is the energy in electron volt that we specify. One is the oscillator strength. This is more or less the absorption or emission. Yeah. Okay. So in principle, everything is done. You can just use whatever software you like to plot the second column against the first column, and then that's your spectrum. Yeah. In our case, we use GNUplot, and as usual, I wrote this script, and it is nothing mysterious. It's actually quite simple. The heart is this line plot, and the name of the file, and using the first two columns, and with the title and with line points. So all of the others are some parameters. Yeah, in principle, you can also do it iteratively, like interactively. Okay. So GNU plot for. Okay, so this is a spectrum, yeah. And let's copy, do a screenshot. And paste it into the Excel so that we can compare. Okay, I'll just paste it here. We don't have much space, so I just put it here. And you see that indeed it is very close to what was calculated before, and also quite close to the experimental curve, that there's a peak here, and then there's a shoulder here, and then two peaks here, and then it dies out at high energy. Okay, and then we want to know what is the peak energy here. So you can choose this zoom, and we just zoom in. So this is around 6.75 electrovolt. So I just write here 6.75 electrovolt, and you see that the error is within 3%, which is very good. Okay, so in this video I've shown you how to calculate the light absorption of benzene molecule using time-dependent DFT calculation in Quantum Espresso. And if you like my video, I would appreciate your like and subscribe to my channel. And thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.